how can you, I guess, do better with personalized medicine? And that's what we're doing. So all the scans are tailored to the patient, but then we take that scan another step further, have a virtual model, and then have a 3D printed physical model. I guess I like to think about it as every body has a story, and we try to help illustrate that.
From a clinical perspective, I would like every patient who is having a cardiac intervention have a 3D print of their heart.
So the genesis of this collaboration really started to begin around us building out that I&E type 3D printing offering with, you know, our students and the faculty and staff members that were using that equipment started to leverage it very effectively against the problems that they had. So of course the thought is, if they're using these relatively cheap tools to solve problems, we could probably solve even greater problems with better equipment.
We can, early on in our experience, we had a child with an incredibly complicated heart, what's called a crisscross heart. And in terms of being able to actually understand the anatomy and the detail to plan the surgery, it was critical to actually be able to turn it over in your hands and look at it. And it made made all the difference in terms of doing the appropriate planning for that child, who's now doing very well as an older toddler.
Was this hole put there on purpose?
So that was put there on purpose. Yeah, that was kind of put there just so we could see it.
So when people come in with a jaw fracture, they're typically what's called comminuted, which means in a lot of different pieces, and it can be difficult to figure out exactly how to put the pieces back together. What we do pretty regularly for the really complicated cases, we'll just get their CT scan and using that print out a model of the mandible and exactly how it's broken. And so before we ever take the patient to the operating room, we know exactly what size plates we want, we know exactly where they go, we know how all the pieces fit together because we played with this little plastic model that we built. That's pretty lifelike.
At Duke, this has really shown the strength of collaboration. It's shown the strength of collaboration between surgery and pediatrics. It's shown the strength of collaboration between radiology and surgery, radiology and pediatrics, radiology and cardiology, and collaboration with Chip and his team in the Innovations Co-Lab. This is a university-wide collaborative effort that is producing incredible results that could really only be achievable at a place like this.